Gearhart's back.
The more things change, the more they stay the same.
From NJ1015.com, this is the new Jim Gearhart Podcast.
Well, again, I'm Jim Gearhart, along with my good friend and esteemed colleague, Bob Williams. If you'd never heard of us, people did, because for 25 years, we did the morning show here on New Jersey 101.5. And Bob, of course, the premier traffic reporter in the country. Later, I want to ask you, Bob, to explain just how traffic reports are done, where the information comes from, just how you do it.
All right.
First, we will try, as we usually do, to kind of lift up a little bit of the edge of the tent and let you peep under there into this bizarre world, the circus going on in there, all the craziness. Yeah. The governor now, Comrade Muprhy, is on a roll. He's got three potential scandals going here in a row. One was the hiring of the convicted corrupt public official, which he doubled down on, says he's proud he did that.
Yeah.
And as we explained last week, it was a brilliant political move, because that way he's going to get the corrupt political vote, the corrupt politician vote.
Yeah.
And that's a lot of votes.
Sure is.
That's a lot of votes out there.
Yep. He's their hero.
The second one was a little sort of nebulous. It's whether he is involved or has appointed a person who supposedly, they say, or allegedly was involved in an illegal money maneuvering scam in the Bahamas,
right,
or something like that. And this person had been paid, what, $2 million by the Muprhy campaign. It's rather involved, and who knows. The big one, though, now is the rape accusation against a person that the governor had appointed to a high position.
Right, by a volunteer from his campaign when he was running.
Well, this business of rewarding people who helped you during the campaign, that's not new. I mean, they all do that.
Yeah.
And so to say, well, he only got the job because he was instrumental in getting the governor elected. Well, of course. Frank Rizzo, the legendary mayor of Philadelphia, once was criticized by a news reporter. I think it was Andrea Mitchell at the time, who now became big on NBC, but she was a local Philadelphia State House reporter at the time. And she accosted the mayor about hiring your supporters. And so Rizzo says, what the hell am I supposed to do? Hire my enemies? And yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, makes perfect sense.
So I can't fault him for that. But one thing that struck me about his response to the rape, which is someone he had appointed who'd been a campaign worker, allegedly had raped, according to her, he had raped her after some sort of a campaign, I guess, meeting. Mm-hmm. But be that as it may, and right now, who knows, what happened.
Right. The details are still coming
out. Got two things here. One is that the governor's response to that was a we thing instead of I am against this we. He included his wife in the statement as if this were some royal family. Did you notice
that? I've heard a little bit of that this, yes.
I don't know what that had to do with it, but he did not. It's almost as he's not responding as the governor officially, sort of keeping all kind of doors open.
Yeah.
But it's as a private citizen, we. And he throws his wife into the woodpile there, or against this.
It'll be very interesting to see what he knew and when he knew and how much he knew or how much he did not know.
I think
know.
The allegation is, or the seriousness of it, that he knew that this charge was out there before he appointed the person back during the campaign. The other thing that struck me as very interesting, where are the demonstrators? Mm. Now, from what you see, and again, I don't know, but from what you see, there seems to be more substance to this allegation, potentially, far more than there was against the Justice Kavanaugh in Washington. Mm-hmm. And as you know, all hell broke loose over that. You know, the mob was rioting in the streets and trying to break down the doors of the Supreme Court, screaming. Where's the mob now? Allegedly, that was because of he was a female molester or something. Where are they now? Yeah. I mean, you turn it around, this is the same sort of an accusation in high place. They're not accusing the governor, obviously. But where's the response from what used to be the Democratic Party? Now, I guess, as is said, the heir to the mob.
You're still here? Video's over. You can subscribe to our channel, click on the logo for more great content from New Jersey 101.5, comment, share, click another video. This one's done.